In this video, we're going to give you the ultimate Canva tutorial for real estate agents. Katie Lance here, founder and CEO of Katie Lance Consulting, the Get Social Smart Academy, and author of the book Get Social Smart. It's episode 281 of the Get Social Smart show, and today we're talking all about Canva for real estate agents. Canva is an awesome tool to create graphics, videos, and so much more, and especially if you're in real estate, it is an awesome tool to be able to take your social media marketing to the next level. You guys know that it's all about getting smarter about social media. That's what we preach and live and teach each and every day, and we love that Canva is a great resource for that. So in this video, I'm going to give you a few simple tips, and then make sure you stay all the way to the end because I've got some great bonus tips for you when it comes to getting started with Canva, whether you're brand new or maybe you have had a Canva account for a while and you're ready to take it to the next level. Ready? Let's dive in. Number one, set up your account. So if you don't have an account yet, you can just go to canva.com, get signed up absolutely free, and you can do that on your computer or your mobile device. I recommend for most of you, I know for myself included, when I'm designing on Canva, I actually prefer designing on the desktop version. On my laptop, I just find it's a lot easier. However, the mobile version is great. So download the mobile app. It's available on any platform. And what I love about the mobile app is it's a great way to access your designs on the go. So if you've created a number of designs and they're saved with it right within Canva, you've got the mobile app, so you can download anything directly to your phone, and it's a really seamless transition. Anything you create on your phone is available on desktop and vice versa. Number two, choose a free or pro account. So when you first start with Canva, I recommend starting with the free account because there's so many great options, and a free account is a great way to kind of kick the tires and make sure it's a good fit for you. But at some point, I do recommend upgrading to a pro account. Now, by the way, I'm not affiliated with Canva. I receive no compensation for talking about this, but I do recommend having a pro account because when you have a pro account, what's nice about a pro account is there's no additional costs. So when you have a free account, there are hundreds, if not thousands, of free templates and elements available, but there's a lot of things that are add-ons. And so when you have a pro account, you don't have to pay any other additional fees. Also, what I absolutely love about the pro account is it just gives you a few more bells and whistles, one of which you can resize images quickly and easily at no extra cost. So if you've got a graphic that's an Instagram size and you want to resize it for Twitter or any other platform, Facebook, you can do that quickly and easily. Also, with the pro account, you have the opportunity to add your brand kit. This is priceless. So if you look at our brand account, we have our colors, our logos, our fonts, and you can do the same thing once you have that pro account. The benefit to that is once you have a pro account, as you start clicking on templates and creating designs, maybe modifying templates or creating your own designs from scratch, it's really easy with a click of a button to add your colors, your logos, and fonts, really easy. So choose the free or pro. I recommend starting with the free, and you can always upgrade to a pro account. Number three, it's time to start creating. So this is where a lot of folks get a little stumped because they open an account, they start exploring, and it's like, oh my gosh, so many options. So let me give you just a few tips. When it comes to creating, I look at any kind of Canva design kind of like a sandwich. You know, with the sandwich, you've got your bread, your condiments, your meat, your veggies, whatever it might be. It's the same thing when we think about designing. So when we think about designing, we want to first start with the dimension. Nine times out of 10, you will choose the Instagram square version because that's something that looks great just about on any platform, whether you're designing for LinkedIn, Facebook, or any platform. So I like to choose that square just to start off with. And then from there, we can look at things like the background. So for a lot of you in real estate, your background might just be a picture of a listing. If you're creating a graphic for a just listed or just sold, you can go over to the uploads feature on Canva and upload some of your best listing photos and then drag those over into your design, and then now those photos are the background. Now you can also add background colors if you prefer your background to be white or one of your brand background colors, you could certainly do that. From there, you're gonna add other elements. So some of the elements available are things like different graphics, stock photos, different things like lines and arrows and things like that. I really believe less is more. I don't think we need a whole lot of bells and whistles, but sometimes a couple fun icons, maybe a little house icon is a fun thing to add to your graphic. And then of course we have text. Again, less is more. So big mistake I see a lot of agents and brokers make with their Canva graphics, especially if it's something you're using on social media, is I find that there's just too much text. So keep it simple. Remember, in your social media posts, you've got your caption, whether you're posting on Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram, you've got the caption to really talk about the details of whatever it is that you want to talk about. Okay, let's get into those bonus tips. Number one, stay consistent. So one of the challenges with Canva, although there's thousands of options, and that's fantastic, that's also one of the challenges, is that there's thousands of options. So stay consistent, pick a few templates, pick maybe two or three templates that you absolutely love. You can search for templates like real estate, you can search the word home, you could search for quotes if you wanna create some wonderful quote graphics, you can search for the word testimonials if you wanna create some great testimonial graphics. But pick two or three, rinse and repeat. And along with being consistent, one of the easiest ways to be consistent is to batch create your content. I'm a big believer in batch creating. We talk a lot about this inside of our Get Social Smart Academy. It's this idea, if you're gonna sit down and create one graphic or video, you might as well create three or four. So, you know, for example, if you're creating one great inspirational graphic, why not duplicate that? And that's an easy thing that you can do right within Canva. There's a little square icon within your design which will duplicate your design. And now you've got the same design duplicated a number of times, you just change out the quote. And that works if you're doing a testimonial. You could create one great testimonial graphic, duplicate that a number of times, change out the testimonial, but you're not reinventing the wheel every single time. Now from there, you can just keep those right within Canva. What's really nice about Canva is you don't have to keep worrying about saving a file. It will automatically save as you go. And so then you can go back whenever you're ready to download those and post those to social media. In fact, Canva even has a scheduler that you can use right within Canva as well, if you'd like, or you can download those and post those organically to social media. But stay consistent, that's number one. Number two, name your file. So this is really important. Canva does automatically save your content as you're creating, but name your file. If you don't name the file, it will either be untitled file, or it'll be whatever text you wrote on your graphic. So I like to think about it in terms of what is something that's searchable, right? So if you're trying to search this down the road, maybe you want to think about naming it the address of a property. If you're doing just listed, maybe it's just listed 123 Main Street. So maybe having the property address inside that graphic or inside the name of the file. If it's a testimonial, maybe we say client testimonial with their name. So just think about it, because down the road, I know for me, a lot of times I'm like, wait, I created something like that 6 months ago. I want to pull that up and just, you know, recreate it. Being able to search it is key. So name your file, really, really important. All right, bonus tip number three is download your file. So I find that once we get to the point where we've created something, we've named something, we're like, okay, now what do we do? So it will certainly live right within Canva. And if you have the pro account with Canva, you can actually organize your files into folders, which is awesome. It's a little bit of an advanced tip, but I also recommend that you download your content. So, you know, a lot of folks that we work with will download their content into Dropbox or Google Drive, and now you've got it nice and organized. So if you're batch creating content for next month, you can create it all in one batch, set aside an hour or two once a month where you're creating it, download it, upload it to perhaps Google Drive or Dropbox, all in one spot, and then you can go in and either post, schedule, or if you have an assistant or someone on your team who's helping with that, they can do that as well. So let me know what you think. Are you active on Canva? Let me know, yes or no, in the comments below. If you're curious about additional templates within Canva, we've got a great video on that. I'm gonna drop that link below as well. If you like this video, we would absolutely love if you'd hit the subscribe button and the bell button if you're watching over on YouTube, because we have new videos that come out each and every week. And if you're listening to this thinking, okay, I gotta take my Canva to the next level, we have an awesome new ultimate Canva checklist for real estate agents. If you go to katielance.com/Canva, put your name and email in, we will send this to you. It is an awesome companion to everything we're talking about today. All right, my friends, I'll see you soon, and I'll see you on Canva.